What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and today we have a really important topic, a really complex topic, but I think it's really worth it to understand it completely in depth, because it can save you so much time and it can help you so much when it comes to working in Revit. And the topic is using filters. Filters are one of the most powerful tools in Revit because they allow you to kind of get the maximum out of, well, BIM, building information modeling. The information that we put into each of the elements that we create inside of Revit, using filters, we can then extract and use that data, for different either design decisions or just manipulating the project in some ways, or even presentation. So in today's video, I decided to go through filters. What are filters? How are they used? And then I'm just going to be showing you on three different examples. I'm going to be showing you first the difference between and/or filters. Then I'm going to be showing you how to use filters in order to fill in certain data that might be missing inside of your model, how to find which elements are missing that important data, and then how to fix that. And then finally, I'm going to be showing you how to use filters for presentation purposes, just to make it easier to tell Revit to display exactly what you want it to display. Now, one of the reasons why I'm doing this, well, of course, it's a really important topic, but the second reason is, well, I'm promoting my course. So I have my beginner to intermediate level course, which has done really good, and a lot of you have loved it. And then a few months ago, this year, I've released the next step, which is intermediate to advanced level course, where I tackle all of the kind of intermediate to advanced level topics, such as filters in Revit. And I have a whole chapter on filters, but apart from that, many different chapters on many different important but also complex advanced topics. So if you're interested in that course, you can find it by following the link in the description just below this video or up in the cards above. And also on my website, you can find many different courses on many different topics, as well as Revit templates if you're interested in those. And also we have some really high quality Revit families and a plugin, so check it out if you're interested. Okay, so now let's talk about filters. So here I am in Revit, as you can see, I'm just going to show you, well, where do you use these filters? Well, if you go here to the visibility graphics overrides and go into edit, you will find that here we have a tab called filters. Now this is the tab where we can add all of our filters, and then we can use them to apply a graphical override to our model. Now this is basically telling you that filters are used on a view-by-view basis. Having them as part of visibility graphics overrides, that basically means that it only affects the view in which you activate that override. Okay, so here in filters, you can see that this is empty. No filters have been applied for this view. So how do you create them? Well, you can add them here, but before you can add them, you first have to create them, and you can create them by going here to edit or new, and then you get this big filters menu, and then this is basically what you use in order to create the filters. Another way to get to filters is simply by going here to the view menu, going to filters, and you get the same menu. And now we're just going to be creating a new filter. Now, before we start with that, something really, really important, I would like to ask you to make sure to like this video, also make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell icon. Not only does it help me out a lot and it helps you not miss any of my future videos, but also it does make the alpaca happy, and let's be honest, that's why we're all here. Okay, once we have done that and we have liked this video and subscribed, now we can continue with the filters. So let's see how to create a new filter. In this case, here you can see that on this side here on the left, we have filters panel, then we have categories, and then we have the filter rules. Now first, let's take a look at the project that we're going to be affecting. So here, as you can see, we have series of walls. Now these walls have different thicknesses, they have different lengths, and also they have different areas. Obviously because of length. So in this video, I just want to use or or show you how to create a filter which is going to give us a different graphical override depending on some of these parameters. So what I want to show you is how to create two filters. One will be an AND filter and then other one will be an OR filter. These are kind of two different options that you can use. So first, let's create the first filter. So you go here to filters, you have this little button that creates a new filter, or alternatively, you can select one of these, and then you can just duplicate them here. So let's create a new one. Let's call this one the walls end. Click OK. And then here, you define the category. Now, you can select multiple categories, or you can select one category. In this case, we're going with walls, so that's just one category. And then here, it will display walls. Now, it's time to make the filter. This is the AND filter. And this basically means that all of the rules you add here, the objects that are going to be affected by this filter have to have all of the rules. So it has to have first rule and the second rule and the third rule. Or if this was an OR filter, then it can be first rule, but also the second rule can work. So if it has the second rule but not the first rule, it's still going to work. Whereas if you have the AND filter, if it has the second rule, kind of it has that, but doesn't have the first one, it doesn't count. That's basically how it works. So let me now show you on a practical example. So here for walls, I'm going to add multiple rules. So here I'm just going to go to walls. Let's start off with the length first. There we go. Then here I'm going to say is greater than, and then let's say 350. This is in centimeters, by the way. And here you can see that multiple options that you can use here. You can use equals, does not equal, greater than or equal, less than, has a value, has no value, and so on. So now we have one. So this is basically if it's longer than this. Now let's add another rule. So this will be for our width. So let's go with width. And then let's say is greater than, and in this case, let's go with 25 centimeters. And also let's add an additional rule, and this one will be the area. And this is also is greater than, and here let's go with 8 square meters. So once we have added all of these rules, we can just hit apply. As you can see, it kind of fills out the units here, and then we can click OK. And now if we go to visibility graphics overrides, go to filter, go to add, now we can find that wall and filter, click OK. And now we can use that to apply any sort of graphical override, both for projection or surface, and then also for cut. So here I can go to perhaps patterns. It's going to give us this menu. And here, let's change the background pattern to solid fill. And let's change the color to some kind of orangish color. Click OK. OK again. Hit apply. OK. And as you can see, these two walls kind of complete or fit into the rules of the filter. So if I go back here to our filters, let's go to wall and see these wall, only these two walls have the length greater than 350 centimeters, have the width greater than 25 centimeters, and have an area greater than 8 square meters. Now let's create a new one. So I'm just going to go to this one, I'm going to duplicate that one and select it, then go to rename, and then let's call this one wall or. Click OK. And now the only change, I'm just going to change this to OR. So instead of being it has to fill out this rule and this rule and this rule, in this case it's going to be if it fills out this rule or this rule or this rule, so just one of these, it's going to fit in. So it's going to be applied. So if now I click apply and OK, I can go back now to visibility graphics overrides, go back to filters, and let's add that OR filter, click OK. Now let's go again to patterns, and in this case I'm going to change the foreground pattern to a hatch, crosshatch, and then let's use, I don't know, like a blue color, click OK, OK, and then hit apply, OK. See, in this case, pretty much all of these, except for this one, fill out those rules. So for just because we've changed from or to and, this is the difference that we have. So you can see even these are affected, but also the rest of these. So that's basically the difference between and or, and that's how filters work inside of Revit. So I thought it was really important to give you like a practical advice on what's the difference between and or. And now let's jump into some perhaps more practical projects where we can see how we can use that. So here, if I go to this project, as you can see here, we have just kind of a simple house and it has some doors. And let's say for these doors, I want to have a finish value added here. So if I select this door, you can see that the finish is gloss. If I select this door, you can see that the finish is satin. But if I select this one, well, we don't have any values, this one as well. So let's say that you have a large project and it's really important to fill out a certain parameter. And let's say that you don't know where that parameter has been added and where it has not been added. And to go kind of manually from one to the other would take a ton of time and you don't want that. Perhaps you have like 100 doors and only two of them are missing that parameter. It would be really annoying to have to go through all of them to see which one doesn't have that, to have to select each one independently. So for this we can use filters. So what you want to do then is just go to view, go to filters and create a new filter. So this will be a door finish filter. Okay, click OK. Obviously the category is going to be doors. There we go. The rule in this case, we only have one rule, so it doesn't really matter is it and or. When you have one, doesn't really matter. Anyways, let's go here and let's find the finish parameter, and then we can say it has no value. So as long as it has no value, the filter is going to change its appearance so we can know which doors have to be edited to include that value. So now if I hit apply and OK, go to visibility graphics overrides, go to filters, go to add that door finish filter, and here let's go to cut lines and let's make it red to kind of make sure we know, and the weight can be like heavy weight. Yeah, click OK, click apply, OK, and now you can see that all of these don't have a value. So now if I come to this one and I can go here to finish, let's say this one is gloss. Now as you can see, it's no longer red. So we can use that now just to kind of easily go through all of these doors and fix the ones that don't have that value applied. And the filter helps us with that. It's quite cool. And let's go to the final project. So the final project is my office building project. So if you haven't seen this, this is one of those projects that's available on my website as a course. This is like a 15 hour course where I show you step by step how to create a complex project such as this one. So check it out. I'm going to include it in the cards above. So if you're interested in this particular course, how to create this cool building. But anyways, let's go here to the floor plan and let's say now that we're creating a sort of a presentation. So we're creating a presentation where we want to kind of display how many tables or desks there are in this office building. As you can see, we have many desks and we want to kind of just make sure that it's visible to kind of a non-architect. So what they want to do now is make sure that all of these desks have a different color, let's say a blue color. Now, if I wanted to just change or override that, I would have to kind of select each desk independently like this, and then I would have to right click and go to override graphics and view by element, and it would take a long time. And especially because I would have to hold the control key and select each individual desk. If I were to try to make a cross selection, even if I filter that down to just furniture, like this, it still selects both the table or the desk, the chair, and the laptop here. And that doesn't really make sense. You don't want all of them, you just want the desk. So what can we do here? Well, here we can search which parameter of this desk we can use. So if I go here into edit type, I can find that here under type comments, we have the regular standing desk. And that's perfect because now I can use that. So I can say, okay, let's go to visibility graphics overrides, go to filters, create a new filter. go here to new filter. Let's call this one the desk filter. Okay, click OK. The category is furniture, so let's see. Furniture, perfect. And then something that's important is the parameter. And as I said, that was going to be a type comments parameter. Now, I know that this chair is called a desk chair, and perhaps in its type comments it has that name. And I don't want to use desk, because both the standing desk and desk chair have the same word. So what I can do is say contains, but instead of desk, I can say standing, because this is a standing desk, after all. Okay, so if I just do this and then hit apply, okay, I can bring that parameter in here, click okay, and now I can just go and change its surface pattern. Let's change the background to solid, and the color, let's make it bluish, but perhaps like this, perfect. Okay, hit apply, okay, and there we go. So now we have only changed this desk, and it was a very easy change. Now, as you can see, filters, the best value that you're going to get from them is in complex projects where you have lots of elements and you don't want to do things manually. And in those cases, filters can save you so much time. So I do really recommend checking them out and exploring them, learning how to implement them in your workflow. And also, I recommend checking out the entire course, which I'm going to link up in the cards above. So you can check out the entire course if you're interested. Thank you for watching. Guys, make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.